there are a lot of ways to make printed circuit boards, but this is really amazing in terms of on-demand customized versions. Could you tell us a little bit about your company?
Yeah, so LPKF Laser and Electronics is a German-based development and high-tech laser company. We have been making PCB milling machines for over 45 years, and in the last 20, the laser systems have been incorporated into PCB laser processing. And here at the show, we have the ProtoLaser U4 system, which is a UV nanosecond laser. It's able to process anything from FR4, Rogers, Taconic, and Panasonic materials, so laminated PCBs, but also fired ceramics, flex, like DuPont Pyrolux TK and AP material, and actually achieved down to 2 mil trace and space on the laminated materials. On fired ceramics and glass, you can actually go down to 1 mil traces or even a little bit below. So this is our 355 nanometer UV laser system, and it's all incorporated as a turnkey unit. Basically, you have a galvo scanner, theta lens, and protection glass all right here. And this air plenum actually is what engages and enables the peeling process, where we isolate and hatch the copper into small strips, and then the laser goes over the top of those strips and defocuses, and it peels off the copper we don't want on laminated PCB materials. So that's the air plenum, and then debris is actually collected and then goes to the laser vacuum unit that's behind the booth here. And then your XYZ table actually has half micron resolution in the XY, and the system itself with the galvo scanner, that's plus or minus 2 micron resolution. And then across the entire work surface, it's calibrated within 10 micron. So extremely precise, very repeatable. And this is where a lot of our customers are doing low quantity production on demand and able to replicate exact geometries that they need for high frequency applications.
Okay. So how about the milling machine version?
So a mechanical milling machine uses carbide tools, high quality tungsten carbide, and can go down to 4 mil trace space and work on the laminated PCB substrates. So it's the longer process, not as fast as laser processing, but a more affordable solution for rapid PCB prototyping, where you can mill the copper, drill the through holes, cut the materials with the mechanical process.
Okay. Now, it sounds as if the laser is faster. Is this something you could actually use for production work, and how big a PCB can you create?
So the laser system can do up to 9-inch by 12-inch boards. You can do production on-demand processing. They can structure the copper off at a rate of 1 to 2 square inches per minute. So LPKF developed a process to isolate, hatch, and delaminate surface copper from those laminated materials. And that allows the heat from the laser to dissipate and still be able to get incredible edge quality, straight sidewalls, and rapid processing all the way up to that 9-inch by 12-inch work area. Quick overview of the software. LPKF Circuit Pro RP is included with every ProtoLaser system. And in that, you basically have settings and materials saved out, which you can start your project, and you would have a wide range in the library of FR4, Rogers, Taconic, ceramics, alumina, and that's all saved in the software. And then as you do your import, you would import your Gerber DXF data. And then you would be able to make sure that it's assigned to the correct layer. And then in the layout, you have your layout view. So top layer, board outline, your through holes, either as drilled, plated, or unplated. And then our software calculates the different tools, and it does that automatically based on the design rules. So if you're going to do structuring of copper, it uses different settings and different separate laser tool profiles, and you compute the tool pass. It only takes a few seconds, and it will calculate all the different tool paths that are needed to do the copper removal. And then your tool paths are ready to go. I can zoom in and show that it's going to do several different tasks, including isolate, hatch, and heat. And then zoom back out, you see the entire project. And then in the processing tab, you have your project. You can just verify that you're over a nice clean area of PCB material. You can move the project around by adjusting the placement. And then I'm gonna start from drilling the fiducials and just tell it to process from there. And so then it will drill the fiducials, and in this case, I'm going to have it read to make sure it's aligned if we were going to be doing a double-sided board or reloading a board. And then it's going to structure the top and then do some drilling and cutting.
Now, does this have any particular advantages when you're going to be dealing with, say, RF type technology?
Yeah, so with RF applications, you can go into the extremely high frequency range, up above 77, 80 gigahertz. And the benefits come from the fact that the laser does not mark into the substrate more than a micron or two.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all adjustable. So you can change the settings to make sure that you're not having an effect or removing some of that substrate like you would with mechanical. Mechanical milling, you will have a limitation on frequency where you might not be able to get above 20 gigahertz. But with the laser processing, you're able to go much higher frequencies.
Mm-hmm.
Your geometries are actually smaller without an under etch. So you're getting straight sidewalls, and with a 15 or 20 micron beam, depending on the laser, or larger on our entry-level machines, you're getting very tight corner radii. And so you're getting geometries that you can't get with a resistant etch process.
Okay, so it sounds like you can actually create PCBs that are actually more accurate than, say, conventional PCB generation.
You can, without the resistant etch requirements as well. The laser even enables trimming where that might be a requirement to make some traces smaller, and even do some embedded resistors or pocketing if you needed to recess components. So mm-hmm. You can use the laser to engrave a channel or a recessed pocket for component as well. Shortens the gold wire bond requirements.
Excellent. Now, is it possible to take an existing PCB and then enhance it using this technique?
You can, yeah. The lasers allow you to do skiving. You can just remove a protective coating. Let's say you accidentally masked over some pads you needed. You can also trim. In that effect, you're not getting active trimming, mm-hmm. or you're getting a feedback measurement. But the laser is so repeatable that if you know what you need to trim off to correct maybe a very expensive circuit board, you can load and fiducial align and then trim or eliminate pads that you don't want in the final version. What's really nice is with the automatic tool change, it actually has a sensor that looks at the collet to make sure that the tool is not already loaded before it goes to pick up another tool. The camera will also look at each tool position, make sure that the tool is sitting correctly to be picked up, or that the collet's empty when it goes to put the tool away. So we put a lot of features in that have made the tool change more user-friendly, prevents accidental mechanical issues, so we don't bump into anything with the movements. And so this basically is nearly automated, and you can walk away while it's doing its milling process, even if it's using 6 or 7 surface milling tools and drill bits and contour routers to make the device.
Very good. Well, thanks for filling us in on LPKF's technology.
Absolutely. Thank you.